Welcome to the FISU World University Games in Chengdu, in the heart of the Sichuan province of China. We're here at the Pidu Gymnasium in the northwest of the city center for the third day of fencing. It's the last day in the individual competition before we switch to the 3 days of team events. Well, now it's time for the men's and women's saber competitions, with the men's coming up first in the semi-finals. In the first semi-final, we've got Jan Kurczewicz of Poland up against Pierre Loisel of France. So we're into the second period, 10 apiece. Power riposte given to Loisel. We'll come down to this next minute, really, and it'll be over. Off target. Well, I don't understand. So he's asking for a video, two off-target lights. Yes, it was for turning his back. And yes, turning. So yellow card to Jurkovic. If he gets another one, then Loisel will gain a point. Now Loisel trying to defend with the line, so putting the line out. Although his arm, I think his arm needs to be straighter than that. Off target. A couple of off targets now. Again, close quarters. Power riposte is signaled, and Loisel takes a 2-point lead. Attack from the left, off target. Look how close the distance is here. Counterattack on the arm there, on the wrist of Jurkovic. And he's got another point there. And after the break, when it was 10 apiece, it's all been one-way traffic for the French fencer. And that is that. Pierre Loisel celebrates. And he is into the gold medal match. As you can see, in that second period, there were 10 all at the break. And then after the break, Pierre Loisel put his foot to the gas and raced through with a 15-10 win. For the second of these semi-finals, it's an all Hong Kong-China affair. Choi is on the right and Chung is on the left. Well, while it was very frenetic in the first period, it slowed right down the scoring, because each point now is vitally important. So attack missed there from Choi. The counter-attack from Chung was on target. And the Olympic champion just a couple of points away from booking a place in the gold medal match. Chung with the attack from the left, and he's now 1 point away from seeing this one through against Choi. Well, thought that Chung would have landed that one, but missed. And the counterattack from Choi. Choi is attacking slowly, off target. Choi with the line out. Well, Well, Choi knows he can't afford any mistakes here. And that was a slight mistake. Choi stepped into distance. Chung able to hit. And Chung Kalong, the Olympic champion, will go through to the gold medal match. So confirmation that Chung Kalong, the Olympic champion, wins that one over his teammate, 15-12. Well, we're moments away from the gold medal bout, and that will be between Pierre Loisel and Chung Kalong of Hong Kong. And here we go, Loisel on the right, Chung, the reigning Olympic champion from Hong Kong, on the left of your screen. A little bit of a slow start to this match, but Chung has got the flow. Ooh, nice. Loisel's attack, still Loisel's attack, parrying, beating the blade and finishing. Chung right on the back line there, trying to glue his heel to the piece. Out of a video review, attack from Loisel onto the arm of Chung. Oh, now, was that Chung's final action? She's giving it to Loisel. So seven apiece. This fight is moving along quite nicely. Off target from Chung. Loisel just taking a little hit to the non-fencing hand. Well, Loisel can't believe he didn't hit there. And he didn't, because Chung is so good at backing away. He can move backwards very fast and leans his body back to avoid the point of his opponent's foil. Chung now trying to build the attack. So he has front foot forward. Nice counter though from Loisel. Power riposte from the French fencer. Now a 2-point lead back to France. And that's accelerated away, 3 points up. Big cheer, because Chung hasn't scored in a while. Has he stopped the rot? Yes. Good stuff from Chung. Levelling it up nicely as we're ticking down towards the break. We're not going to see a third period. That's for sure. Chung's attack. Chung for me. And it is 11 apiece with 18 seconds left on the clock for this first period. Chung's attack again makes it 12-11. Loisel with his mask off, just looking at this coach. Loisel's attack. Loisel's point, 12 apiece. Chung, off target. Loisel coming forward, Chung backing off into the hatching. Right on the back line now, steps over, no. Well, the referee called a halt because we went to the break. not, I don't think, because Chung stepped over the back line, but they are just checking that. That's what they're looking for, because no hit was scored. It was whether Chung stepped over the back line. It's all about the foot here. Does that stay in the hatching? Does the toe stay in the hatching? I think it does. Well, now a card, a red card, gives a point to Chung. I don't understand. He's saying that they were on the break. So he turned around and walked off because the referee called halt. That's a very unusual decision to give Loisel a red card there and give a point to Chung. That one will be argued about for a long time to come. And we're back underway with this second period. Loisel really feels that he was hard done by that. But accepts that Chung got him there, and Chung just 1 point away. Given, and Chung Kalong has done it. Chung Kalong, the Olympic champion, has taken the gold medal here at the World University Games in Chengdu. And it was a scrappy affair in the end, but Chung Kalong is the gold medalist. And confirmation of the score, 15-12 in the end for Chung Kalong. So confirmation that the Olympic champion Chung Kalong has taken the gold medal here in Chengdu. And Pierre Loisel, the French fencer, takes the silver, with Kurovich and Choi of Hong Kong taking bronze. So we're moments away from the first semi-final in the women's sabre competition, and it's between Choi Ji-young of Korea and Malina Marie Vongzavadi of France. So Malina Vongzavadi of France, on the right of your screens, is up against Choi Ji-young of Korea on the left. And that was a big point for Choi, first point in a while. And stopped the run of Vongzavadi. Choi started that one, and Vongzavadi now asking for video review. So, point stands, 12-9 the score. Vongzavadi accepting that one. First attack, no, and Choi picking up the right of way there. Choi's attack, but it was parried. And just 3 points in it, still possible for the French fencer. Vongzavadi a little quicker off the line. Now Choi just 1 point away. Choi's going to build a long attack here. Vongzavadi backing up. Can she finish? Yes, she can. And Choi is through to the gold medal match. A big win for the Korean. And Vong Zavadi deciding to take it out of the middle. A risky tactic when you were 14-11 down. And Choi is through to the gold medal match. And there it is. 15-11, confirmation of the score. So we're moments away from the second semi-final, and it will be between Sarah Nucha of France and Xiao Yehe of China. So the attack from Xiao there was parried, and there, that was the parry. Another parry riposte there from Nucha, and has closed the gap to just 3 points. A good little run here from the French fencer. Has to have the confidence she can get back into this. Oh, lovely sky hook, or stop cut, as we like to say. So not Chow's right of way, but she just caught Nucha on the wrist and then got out of the way. Parried from Nucha. 3 points in it. Again, a big point from Nucha. Superb parry riposte. Oh, Nucha just falling short. Xiao backing away. Nucha's attack. Oh, Xiao manages to beat her with a distance. And then picks up the right away and takes it through to 14-11. Nucha so close there, but attacked into that closed line. Attacked into the guard of Xiao. It's so noisy in here that they really can't hear the referee calling Ale. Xiao's attack. Oh, lovely counter from Nucha. 2 points in it. Can Xiao see this one through and get China into the gold medal match? The locals would love to see that. Oh, it's gonna be Xiao's. And 15-12 the score. So confirmation that Xiao Yehe is through, 15-12 over Sarah Nucha of France. So time now for the women's sabre gold medal bout. It's a matchup between Choi Ji-yun of Korea and Xiao Yehe of China. We start the second period with the youngster Choi with some work to do, and immediately 1 point back. Choi again attacking but falling short. Xiao now building with a long attack, finishes it cleanly. Nine-five the score. Preparation from Xiao. So she came in as she was attacking. She was searching for the blade, moving her saber around. Well, that time, Reza Bekara of Iran, the referee, just decides to go and have a look at that one himself. And finally, the point is given. Xiao Yehe goes to 10, make that 11, 6 up. Preparation called on Choi. And Choi sending the referee to the video to have a look at that. Just over their shoulders, we can see. Was there preparation there? Was there a stop? Well, there wasn't. There was not a stop. And you could actually see that quite clearly on the video review that the referees watched. And two quick points from Choi. It's closed the gap, just 3 points in it. Shao, para riposte, can't land on the riposte. And Choi. That is a beautiful attack from Shao. Shao's attack again, building. Oh, she's off the back line. Off the back line and down. So Shao gets the point without needing to score the hit. So 13-9, Shao, oh, preparation again called on Choi. Well, went to a video review the last time, and she was successfully defending the call of preparation. So preparation is when you started your attack, but then you look for your, I think there was more of a call for that one to stand. Well, let's have a look. No hit. So at that time, it wasn't overturned, just nothing given. There we go, Choi coming through. Again, 3 points the lead. Choi just came in and stopped. Just stopped and waited, looked for the parry, couldn't find her, and Shao is now just 1 point away and has got it with a counter. Shao has taken the gold medal and the noise levels go through the roof here. Shao has taken gold. It's a confirmation of the score, 15-10 in the end, and Shao Yaji of China takes the gold medal. And congratulations to Shao Yaji taking the gold medal for China in her home university games. Choi of Korea takes the silver, and the two French fencers, Nucha and Von Zavadi, take the bronze.